Hi guys, today I'm going to go through a quick tutorial on how fast it is to set up your own display. And today I'm going to be going through the tutorial using the web app. So just log in to app.mangomirror.com. So that's where you want to go to start. And we're going to add a new display. And you have a couple of options in here, so you can actually choose to, you know, use any web browser as your display, so a PC, Mac, iPad, Raspberry Pi, Smart TV, or other browsers. Or if you've got the Mango Display Android app on like an Android tablet or an Amazon Fire tablet or Fire TV, you can choose this option. For this demo, I'm going to choose this option, and I'm going to choose a demo and go display. Okay, so I'm going to rename that, and then you're pretty much done. What it does for you is it creates a new URL specifically for your display, and this is the URL, so I'm going to open that up just to check it. By default, it would have the clock set there, and then you continue to go to your display settings. So you go to your display settings, and all the changes you make here will be reflected back on this, on your display here. So this is the specific URL that you're working with. You can copy this and use it on any browser, any smart TV, anywhere you want your display to be shown. So as you can see, I moved it to the left. It automatically gets moved around. And then quickly, I can go in and add background images. I'm going to choose Unsplash as an option. And I like to see the night sky, so I'm choosing night sky as a background. You can obviously choose your Google Photos, Apple Photos, you know, if you want to use them as backgrounds, there's options in there. You can choose the brightness of the photos themselves. You want to keep it a little bit dark if you've got a lot of text. So if you got a lot of text you want to read, you want to keep that a little bit dark. And then you can choose how often you want the photos to change in the background. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. And we can check our display out. It should start to show you the backgrounds now as soon as it saves. Okay. Oops, what happened there? Let's splash. There you go. It just took a while to load up. And so there you see the backgrounds with the clock widget in there. I'm going to go ahead and change that clock widget for now. Let's add the calendar. Let's add a Google account. So it's going to ask you which account do you want to use. We've got a demo one set up here, so I'm going to use that. Okay, and then once you log in, basically this grants Mango Mirror authorization to just see your events on your calendars so they can be displayed. And if you want to read any details about our terms of service or privacy policies, you can click on that. And as always, you have the option to remove access in your Google account. So I'm going to allow this for now. Okay, once you do that, you'll see your account selected in here. And if you've got multiple calendars within that account, you'll have them all show up here, and you can choose to select which ones you want to see. And you enable the widget. To start off with, I'm going to go with maybe let's do a month view. Okay, and all of those. And obviously, it's going to look tight now because everything's just jammed into that one line. So what you want to do is move this pretty much to cover the full screen. What I will do is maybe move the clock out for now so I can remove the clock out. Delete the clock. Give the calendar basically the full space. Okay, and as you see, that's saving right now, and once that saves automatically, we should see our calendar appear here. There you go. The backgrounds remain as is, and we've got some demo events here. It identifies the date with a different color. Okay. We can also flip it around, so we can change it to, for example, if we only want to see upcoming events, we can change it to, for example, list view. Let's say I only want to see five events. That's good enough for now. And as soon as that saves, you'll see that it shows up here on the left. So this allows you to do multiple things. So you can have your calendar, show events here. You can bring in things like your clock. Okay. So I have my clock, my calendar. You can make these smaller as well. They don't have to be the same size. So, and I'm going to add weather. It's usually what we need. Brampton, Ontario. I'm going to choose today's weather of the 24 hours and leave my unit of display at Celsius. I'll leave my 24-hour forecast there. I'll leave my day forecast right there. And I think that's good enough for the first screen. So let's check it out. Let's see how it looks here. Once that saves, it's going to reset. And this is perfect. So you got the backgrounds changing behind. You've got your calendar, you've got your weather, and you've got your clock as well. So what I'd like to do here now is maybe add another screen, and you can ignore that. We're just working on some tests right now. And here I am going to add maybe quotes. To have quotes there. I'm going to choose, life. Still going to enable it. And I think that's good enough for default. And let's say you want to keep your calendar on all the screens, right? So basically you've got two screens now, and they're each time to move for, like, this one's time to flip in 10 seconds, this one's time to move in 30 seconds. So what I'd like to see is my calendar on both screens, so I can go here and I can actually pin it. So I can pin the calendar widget, and it's going to ask me, it's visible on all pages, you want to continue? I go yes. And now you'll see that it automatically shows up here as a pinned widget. And now let's take a look at how it looks. So this is the first screen where we had events, and we had a weather there, and this is the second screen. So you still got your events there, and you've got your quotes in here. So you can add as many as you like those screens. And that's pretty much it. Once you've got the setup, you're good to go. And you don't have to come back and reconfigure anything. Your events get automatically updated based on Google. So all of your latest events deleted or added will be displayed in here. That's pretty much what I want to show you. I think that's a quick demo for today. It just shows you how easy it is to set it up, and I hope you enjoy. If you've got any questions, please feel free to comment using our chat options within the app, and I would be happy to assist you. Thank you.